You've heard the expression, failing is not an option. Well, in Forex, it is an option. And most of the time, it is exactly that, an option. So the good news is there are proven reasons why traders fail, and we're going to take a look at them. I'll also highlight a number of brokers and their losing percentages. So let's get started. The first mistake among newbies is they think they can outsmart the market. Having the beating the market mindset often causes traders to trade way too aggressively or even go against trends, which is a recipe for disaster. Instead, what you want to do is befriend the market and hop on board when you're confident about your trade. The second biggest mistake is that most traders start out because they think it's a way to get rich quick. They might be looking for a way to get out of debt or to make easy money. But be wary of Forex brokers who push beginners to use the highest leverage available. This is a sure way to lose and keep your emotions running high. This is not the way you want to start out in Forex, and even though brokers are running a business themselves, they generally want you to trade carefully. The third mistake is failure to manage risk. Risk management is key to survival as a Forex trader. You could be a very skilled trader and still blow up your account if you have poor risk management. Your number one focus should not be to make huge profits, but rather to protect what you have. For example, you go all in on one trade with the highest leverage possible. The trade goes south, your capital gets depleted, and your ability to make a profit is lost. Boom, trade and career over. Proper risk management uses stop loss orders and lot sizes that are reasonable compared to your account capital. Most of all, if a trade no longer makes sense, get out of it. The fourth mistake is greed. Some traders feel that they need to squeeze every last pip out of the market. This can cause you to hold positions too long, and you could potentially make a huge loss on a trade that was actually profitable a few moments ago. There is money to be made in the Forex markets every day, so don't be greedy. Let the trade run until your original take profit set has been reached, and then pocket the profits. If the trade continues to profit after you are out, well, don't dwell on it. You've stuck to your plan, made your profit, and the next opportunity is right around the corner. The fifth mistake is hanging on for dear life. Well, this is the ultimate killer to any trading account. Please don't hold on to a losing trade hoping that it's going to turn around. If you trade this way, you end up with much more exposure than you planned. Some trades just don't work out. And as a trader, you just have to accept that you're wrong sometimes and move on. The best thing to do is just to admit the mistake, dump the trade, and move on to the next opportunity. Okay, so now you know what not to do. Let's take a look at the most popular Forex brokers and see what their losing rates are. Markets.com has a losing rate of 64%. This, at the moment, is actually the lowest losing rate that we've found. eToro is in second place with a current losing rate of 66%. And please note that I said current losing rate because every so often these brokers are obliged to update this information on their website, so it can change from time to time. Then we have Oanda with a 77% losing rate, Easy Markets with 79%, and Plus 500 with 80.6%. So the good news is none of these brokers have a 90% losing rate. And another thing to know that is if the broker's website does not display the percentage of losing accounts, then run. Now, if you're not ready for real trading yet, you can test the waters with the Trading Game app. It's 100% free and uses real-time data so you can get a feel for the market without risking anything. I will, of course, leave all the links below so you can check them out. So with that being said, good luck trading.